a fine old country house somewhere in the South come the privileged visitors. No, it's not a club, nor is this a weekend party. The war has changed all that. The visitors have come to report to the supervisor of a powerboat training center before starting a 2 months course in, well, what do you think? You'd be wrong anyway. They've come to learn how to make speedboats. And you can't make a speedboat without knowing something about screws. This is where they pick up the thread, so to speak. The girls are of many types, but they're all keen to get down to the practical work. In the carpenter shop, they learn such arts as drilling and planing, and there was never so much virtue in a vice. Joints and various other metal parts the girls can make after a few weeks' training. And most of the trainees have proved as sharp as the tools they keep sharp. They study graphs with all the air of old-timers. Here's the workshop's filing system, and this is the scribe for marking wood or metal. You can see that they're certainly girls of parts. An even more ambitious job is that of welding, and some of them can handle a blowtorch as expertly as a man. So the course progresses to the actual building of the boats. Sleek 16-foot dinghies capable of very high speed and used mainly in rescue work. Now, this girl is boring the hole for the propeller shaft. It's just one of the many construction jobs the trainees do in completing the hulls. They've already done a great deal of the interior work at the bench, but there are many stages yet before the hull is finished. The girls are making sure that when this boat's pushed out, it's going to be well worthwhile. These are some of the girls who are doing their bit for victory. They're taking the place of the men who have joined the fighting services, and they're doing a great job, speeding up the speedboats.